Everyone loves dogs, but some dogs aren't pets. Idaho sheep ranchers use special dog breeds to protect their flocks from predators. Livestock guardian dogs have been bred to fend off coyotes, wolves, bears, and mountain lions from killing sheep. The dogs are a non-lethal method of protecting sheep. It's a long-standing best practice used widely by sheep ranchers across the West. Worldwide, livestock guardian dogs have been used to ward off predators for over 2,000 years.
The coyotes and the wolves are the number one cause of mortality in our herds. And the white dogs, Great Pyrenees, Ocbosh, they have shown, it's proven that they decrease the predation that we have in our herds and keep the livestock safe.
Without the dogs, coyotes would have a heyday with our sheep and they would drag off our livestock one by one, wolves, bears, lions. Livestock guard dogs and sheep herds have been going hand in hand for many, many generations, and there's good reason for that.
In the last year, a number of guard dogs were picked up by people on BLM or national forest lands, thinking the dogs were pets that were lost or abandoned. But in fact, the dogs were not lost. They were out in the field protecting the sheep.
Usually I only get, I get a call or two a year about, that there are dogs wandering on the forest, but this year they were actually taken. From what I understand, by the time we were able to get a hold of the livestock producers, the dogs were going to Montana.
Some people have good intentions. They're dog lovers and they want to make sure the dogs are okay. But in the last year in Idaho, several guard dogs have been stolen, transported out of state, and presumably sold for cash. Under Idaho law, it's a felony to remove livestock guard dogs from the range. Last winter, a Washington man picked up three guard dog puppies at the Solon Ranch near Emmett and took them home to Western Washington, some 450 miles away. A neighbor tipped off Harry Solon that he had the man's name and phone number. Solon called the man and asked him to return the dogs immediately. He refused. When guard dogs are puppies, they're released into the sheep herds to bond with the sheep. Any interruption in that routine could ruin the bonding and training. Solon filed a criminal complaint with the Gem County Sheriff's Office. Overall, sheep ranchers want people to know that guard dogs are out on the range for a specific purpose, to protect the sheep. They aren't lost. Please leave them be. The advice is similar to finding a deer fawn in the woods. Please leave it be.
If the dog is not injured or if it just looks lost, I would leave it alone because those dogs, more times than not, know exactly where the band is. These dogs do have an amazing sense of direction and they can smell and hear more than humans can. It's pretty amazing. And they know exactly where they're at in that country. This is not their first rodeo.
In 2020, with the COVID-19 pandemic, a sharp increase in outdoor recreation occurred. Many of them were newbies.
People don't understand. They haven't been in the mountains as much. This year with the pandemic, we see more people in the South Hills where our sheep are than we've ever seen before. And with a little bit of education, if sheep producers would put a collar and a nameplate on their dogs, then it will alleviate a lot of these problems.
Guard dog collars typically include the name of the dog and a phone number to call.
For me, I'd appreciate a phone call over taking my dog. Because more often than not, I have to go 2.5 hours out of my way to acquire the dog and then return it back to the point where he was going in the first place.
Emmett rancher John Peterson also puts ID on his guard dog collars.
It's like a cow tag, but it says I am a sheep guard dog and what his name is, and then a phone number that you're hoping if the people encounter the dog and they see that, they'll figure he's where he's supposed to be.
An increasing number of guard dogs are getting picked up by mistake in the Wood River Valley and Sun Valley area, a region with high tourism traffic. Last summer, Peavy read on Facebook that someone had picked up his guard dog puppies at a corral on private land, thinking they had been abandoned. In fact, Peavy had left them there on purpose while he went grocery shopping in Haley.
By the time I was heading back, I saw posts on Facebook about this rancher who had abandoned his puppies and that they were starving and didn't have any water and that nobody was there to look after them. And this is just like a complete extreme portrayal of what the situation actually was.
Peavy connected with the people via social media and got his dogs back.
It can get out of hand pretty quick.
A quick phone call can avoid a situation where guard dogs are taken away and exposed to a domestic situation that could damage years of training, Peavy says.
Shouldn't be taking a dog out of its environment, bringing it home, causing it undue stress, and exposing it to unnecessary domestication and kind of reversing my process.
Some of the most common breeds used in Idaho include Great Pyrenees, Akbash, and Anatolian Shepherds. Ranchers invest a lot of time into training the dogs. There's a fine art to training them so they bond with the sheep, but also obey their human handlers, ranchers say.
You just don't have dogs and you just stick a bunch of dogs with a band. We've had, you know, good luck. You put the pups with lambs, they imprint with the sheep. You don't want to handle them a whole lot at that time in their life.
At this point, they want the dogs to bond with the sheep, but they also want the dogs to bond with and listen to the sheep herders overlooking the sheep.
That's the fine line there that we've had dogs go both ways. We've had dogs we didn't handle enough, and they go out with the sheep, and by fall, they're pretty much feral. You can't catch them.
I grew up out here on the ranch, and I grew up with the dogs, and like any young boy, I'm fascinated with the puppies, and I've just always been close with the dogs on the ranch. But if I'd get caught petting a puppy in a corral, I'd get harked at by the sheep foreman or my grandfather saying, "Don't touch those dogs, they'll learn to love people more than they love sheep and won't do their job." So, you know, of course I'd still pet them when they weren't looking. So I'd learned that I could still make friends out of some of these dogs. They can learn to appreciate people, do their job just fine. The trouble is, if these dogs don't receive any affection from people at a young age, as a puppy, and even just periodically throughout their life, then they grow up wild, they grow up feral. And when you need to catch a dog, especially when it's wounded or needs medical attention, you can't. I mean, it's next to impossible.
There's also a fine line in training when it comes to a guard dog's temperament around outdoor recreationists, Peterson says.
You want a dog that you can handle, and you want a dog that's not vicious. This year with the COVID on our spring range, there was people everywhere, mountain bikers and hikers. You can't have a dog that's vicious. So you want a dog that's, you know, he's bonded with the sheep, he's a good defender, and he's not a liability as far as hurting people or, you know, biting a mountain biker or something.
Typically, the guard dogs will be raised to about 1 year old before they join the sheep on the range. Prior to going into the field, the dogs get wormed and vaccinated by a veterinarian. It's imperative to get the dogs neutered or spayed to ensure they don't get sidetracked on the range, trying to find a female dog in heat. In the spring, when it's time for the sheep to follow the green up into the mountains, the guard dogs are bonded with the sheep and sheep herders, and they're ready to do their job. Sheep ranchers typically use at least 2 guard dogs for each band of sheep, and sometimes more. In the field, guard dogs fend off predators in several ways: marking the edges of the grazing territory, barking or engaging when a predator approaches, confronting a predator directly. Sometimes more than one guard dog will approach a threat and work together. It's great when all the training and care leads to a good set of guard dogs that work together to protect the sheep, Peterson says.
Last year, I think we had the best group of dogs we ever had. We had wolves around us on our summer range most of the summer, and we had no confirmed kills.
That's the ideal situation. Some years, however, predator kills can be bad, and even the guard dogs can get mauled or killed by wolves.
Last year I lost, one night we lost one guard dog and the other one got tore up really bad. Had to take it into the vet. And that really pulled at my heartstrings. These dogs are willing to give their life, protect these sheep.
Idaho range sheep operations cover huge swaths of country from spring to summer range. The dogs hike hundreds of miles with the sheep, guard them, and sleep with them 24/7. Oftentimes, they can hear coyotes or wolves howl in the dark of night. In late August, early September, when lambs are shipped to the market, the guard dogs hang out nearby. They lie quietly in the frosty meadow while the lambs get loaded on the stock trucks. In the coming days, it's time to start the long journey back home with the ewes. This is a time when guard dogs can get temporarily separated from the sheep. In a place like the Wood River Valley, ranchers trail the sheep through a number of subdivisions on their way to Muldoon Canyon and the Flat Top Ranch.
The dogs have to leapfrog larger areas of civilization before they can get to where the sheep need to go. And the problem occurs usually when we're coming home. We have to cover vast amounts of differences. We have to go through subdivisions alongside town. Dogs get distracted. I've established relationships with as many people as I possibly can in the Wood River Valley so that when I'm looking for my dog and I'll know when one is missing, I have a great probability of finding it just by word of mouth. And then when I do, it's really easy for me to load them up, take them home.
If people see a dog that may have been separated from the sheep herd, check for a number on the dog's collar to call. Or contact the nearest BLM or Forest Service office. But please, leave the dog in the field.
Shoshone has about 36 bands that move all the way down. They cross the Snake River all the way up to Galena Summit, and we track them every day. We know where they're at. We contact us.